Each journey into the woodland or forest can be a way to reach the inner self, into the oneness of being, back to the divine within. We have lost our true purpose for life. We have moved away from the true nature of ourselves. We have lost contact of the circadian rhythm of the planet. We have become locked into the cities where sacred geometry controls our ideas of self. There is a need to return to the oneness of all beings, and nature can take us there. For centuries, writers, theologians, and psychologists have eulogized about the forest and woodlands, and no wonder. Each journey into the woodlands takes us to another world, another place beyond time as we understand it. A world that is beyond man's fixed idea of time. A world where it takes at least five generations of humans to follow the life mastery of a single tree. We must be aware of the fact that nature and the elementals are sharing their gifts. There is a requirement of a balanced exchange of energy. Man is so used to seeing everything as a treasure to plunder, something to use for his own gain. But nature reminds us that balanced exchange means all of life gains. You are never alone in the woodland. There are many witnesses to your presence, along with the birds, insects, trees and flowers. There are the elementals who have entered their homeland, their homes, and they will interact with you if they so wish to. But it must be on their terms. They will only reveal themselves to you if they have read your energy and found it conducive and welcoming. You may get just a quick glimpse of them. Remember, they are masters of their realm and may choose to be mysterious, or others may play games and tricks on you. If you stumble, it may not be because you are being clumsy. You are being reminded you are not the all-powerful human you may believe yourself to be, who is there to just take whatever you choose, be it sight, sound, or a physical object. Though the woodlands are sacred places, they are not solemn. There is plenty of joy and excitement to be seen amongst the communities. There is a hive of activity, especially from the birds. The woods are a metaphor for life. As in life, the woods give us a glimpse of the beauty, the stillness, the tranquility, and challenges. The sanctuaries require changes and a shift in our perspective beyond the literal jungles of our modern life. We have to see beyond the dense undergrowth of the daily mental chatter, the rules and regulations which are often blocking our way, to the beauty and calm within us. The visitor should have no prime intent of seeking the wisdom, but with an open heart and a calm and balanced wish to connect with the essence of the tree. Remember, you are entering a sacred place. If your heart is open, true communication can take place. But the purity of intention is vital, for all elementals recognize it, as opposed to someone wanting to gain without any idea of equal exchange. You are stepping into another land with other rules, other forms of life. You are a guest, but unless your heart is pure, you will become an intruder. The animals and nature spirits have been maligned and abused over the centuries. It is up to us to clear away the negativity and lies laid down to lock them in and control their influence, to stop them assisting us to move back into balance with Mother Nature and the planet. Only by studying and observing the fauna and flora and the creatures of the woodlands can you get a true sense of their gifts of wisdom for you. Even the colours of the woodland offer us colour therapy. The green brings us the true colour of the heart. It represents centeredness, balance, and neutrality of the woodland. The oranges and reds of the new shoots of the leaves represent the two lower chakra energy centres. Although red is the slowest of the wavelengths within the visible spectrum, it is the most stimulating of colours. The red root chakra commands attention. It signals danger to us. We act immediately. The colour of the life force is red. It is the colour of blood and the first colour we come into contact with when we are born. Red means pure energy and our connection with the earth, and carries the promise of survival. While the root chakra is satisfied with survival, the second chakra, the orange, seeks pleasure and enjoyment. The gift of this colour is experiencing our lives through feelings and sensations. It is a center of feeling, emotion, pleasure, sensuality, intimacy, and connection. Yellow is full of intellectual and creative energy. A fun colour, it makes us feel vibrant, happy and optimistic. It represents personal power and fulfilment, abundance, courage and self-confidence, feeling free to be all that we can be. Man has moved away from nature so much that the true laws of abundance seem incongruous and just an old mythology to him. When we work within nature's system, we are always supplied with what is truly required, but not the artificial needs and desires we have been told we need to keep the false man-made systems going. Nature is never parsimonious. Her overwhelming abundance is evident everywhere. She is always offering us an amazing supply of potential opportunities for growth. There are literally billions of seeds released each season. It's been calculated that a jay can bury up to 3,000 acorns in a season. The woodland shows us the rich diversity of life, the abundance in many varied and different forms. It reminds us that we all are unique and have differing soul purposes and cannot be all the same. Each species demonstrates their unique attributes and the strengths and qualities. Even the seed cases, which have been a protection for the vulnerable and tender shoots, now fall to the ground and will provide sustenance and shelter for the ground-living creatures. Man is always talking about shortages and scarcity and lack. The woodland rebukes this statement with its abundance, its copious production, its use of energy, of sunlight. It supplies the needs of all who live within its boundaries. The woodlands are full of life. There is movement and activity everywhere. But death is here too. It has to be. For in a world of polarity, for life to exist, death must surely be. Death and what we see as destruction are a vital part of our lives. The old has to give way to the new. Sometimes change is dramatic and swift. Death takes away much we shared and cared for. Its finality forces us to let go, release our relationships, careers, ideas, beliefs, status, everything. These events clear away patterns which have served us, but which now, if we cling to them, will hinder any new growth, any new potential. It will stifle the new and tender shoots of aspiration and vision. The light can now enter the closely contained spaces, offering new species, new ideas, new beginnings, which we revel in once the dense undergrowth of constriction and old world growth patterns of being and seeing. Death sponsors and supports life. The old foundations can feed the new, but a breakdown of old structures is required to provide nutrients for the new. The old crumbles away. A new form of life replaces the declining, decayed past. Death offers us time to reflect, to go within and re-examine our lives, our values, our ideals. Sometimes we experience the loss of a pattern which had developed within a relationship. But we need to remember, death is always an opportunity for re-evaluation, re-examination, to realign our beliefs and thoughts, and even our ideas, our ideals, values, and our direction. Once overshadowed and now free to expand, unrestricted, the influence and even the domination is now gone. Old ideas and beliefs of the strength of others are now shown to be false. We have not seen the decay and the neglect of those we took for granted, those we believed were there for us forever. New light is cast onto old patterns and restrictions. Unrecognized support systems are now gone. Space is created to explore new possibilities. They have been half hidden under the shade and protection of others. We are now in the full glare of the light. No more hiding. We now stand or fall by our own efforts. When a tree dies and falls, it provides food for the beetles and the fungi called mycelium, the mosses and woodlice. These beings transform the wood into life-giving energy. The wood-boring beetles and the mycelium play their part in breaking down the structure of the tree. And then they too become food themselves for the birds, like the woodpeckers. The woodpecker is known as the trickster, because they drill holes in the dead trees to provide supposed safe spaces for the larvae and grubs of the beetles to hide away, little knowing the birds will return for a succulent meal and complete another cycle of life and death, back to life again. In the next film, I will introduce you to some of the wise masters of the woodlands, the trees and the birds.